I've been truly blessed over the last few weeks at Trust Reviews. Not only did I get the Oculus Rift a couple of weeks ago, I now have the HTC Vive, and it's heavy, in my hands. Now, what we're gonna do is find out what's inside. Let's get this top off. So, let's start with the boring bits first. These plain looking boxes are the sensors. The way these work is there's one located at one corner of the room, the other located at the other corner of the room, and they talk to each other. In the middle, you'll be standing and walking around, and it can register where your headset is, so where your head is positioned, but also where the Vive controllers are, which is great. One thing about these are that they actually require quite a bit of installation, so you might either have to drill into a wall to get them the brackets installed so they can sit nice flush, or you'll have to find some tool cabinets to put them on top of. They also require power, but they don't require any network connectivity because they actually talk to each other via infrared. So, tell you what's a little bit more interesting, these fantastic controllers. Now, these are true VR controllers. This isn't like the Xbox One controller, which kind of gives you some good VR experiences, but not really true to life ones. These actually let you move around. They let you aim and shoot with these awesome triggers. They also have these clever little buttons here, the graspers. So as you kind of tighten your fist, they click. Means that it feels like you're really picking something up. If you're moving down in virtual reality to pick up something, you clasp those. It just immerses you even more. Now, they're not small, but what is really great about these is that when you're in the virtual reality environment, you actually see them, so you know where you're holding them. If someone hands them to you, you can actually see them and reach out and grasp them, which is fantastic. Now, before I get the headset out, let's have a little look at this link box. Now, the HTC Vive headset doesn't actually connect directly to a PC. Instead, it connects via this little box here. Now, this is also powered, so there's another plug there. So you've already got two plugs taken up by the sensors and a third plug for the actual headset, for this link box that powers the headset. Now, we know what we're all here for. It's this baby. This is the HTC Vive headset. Now, it feels really heavy to start with, but that's because there's an awful lot of cable here. Just don't forget, you can walk around with this, unlike the Oculus Rift, which is a standing or sitting experience. This is one where you can walk around the room and interact with different things in different environments. Now, don't worry about bumping into stuff. You'll be able to create your room environment and tell the Vive where the limits are, so where the walls are. Once you start getting too close, a virtual grid appears in front of you so you don't smash your face in. It's very, very clever. There's another element that's really clever, which is this front camera. So this lets you see what's going on without taking the headset off. So if you really need to pick up your phone or have a look at the time or something like that, you can flip this on and see what's going on in the real world via the HTC Vive. It's clever stuff. Now, the only other thing that you can adjust and do on the headset is via this little sort of twisty button here. This lets you change the angle and orientation of the lenses to make them focus better. Let's get this on. It feels nice and comfortable. Obviously, I can't see anything because we haven't got it connected to a PC yet. Kind of feels a little bit like it might fall off, but that's because I haven't really adjusted it yet. So I will do that. But the only other thing to note is that it doesn't come with any headphones. So I think there might be somewhere in here a set of sort of EarPod style headphones. But what you're really going to want with a VR experience is a headset. So what you do is you take a headset, if you've already got one, and you plug it in to this 3.5 mm jack right here. So that will give you your audio. put it all together though, and this might start getting a little bit heavy. We're gonna go off and test that right now, and I can't wait. Let's get going.